Come and join us on Thursday, November 26, 10 a.m. here at Resurrection House for All Nations as we gather to begin our day, giving thanks unto the Lord our God. Invite your family and friends to come as we recognize and celebrate the goodness and faithfulness of the Lord to us throughout the year. Tickets are available for the 13th anniversary Black Tie Banquet, January 10th, 2016 at the Georgia International Convention Center in College Park. Invite your family, friends, co-workers, neighbors to join us. Get those gowns and tuxedos ready. It's a black tie affair, complete with ministry, dinner, and featuring the guest ministry of world-renowned singer Micah Stampley. Reserve seating is $100. General admission, non-reserve seating, $75. Children's tickets are $50 for reserve seating and $35 for non-reserve.
Beloved, I'm so excited as we conclude this week in the mighty name of Jesus. The time for my breakthrough is finally here. The God that made me a promise is visiting me with glory and power and blessing in Jesus' name. Beloved, destiny has a way of bringing things around. Now the famine that was global affected Canaan, and Joseph's brothers had to come to Egypt by Jacob's command to get bread. We read it yesterday, but I want to read it again. And the Bible says, and Joseph was governor, verse 6 of Genesis 42. And Joseph was the governor over the land, and he it was. Joseph was governor. Even the way that reads, it's just amazing. Was governor over the land. The slave, the betrayed, the one in jail has become the governor because God said so. All things are possible with the Lord. Believe it in your life, beloved. And as I always said, even if your struggle with sickness ends in death, you will be rewarded in His presence. All things are possible. Believe it. It won't cost you anything. Let go of your doubts. May God visit you today. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And Joseph was the governor over the land, and he it was that sold to all the people of the land. And Joseph's brethren came and bowed down themselves before him with their faces to the earth. They bowed themselves down, beloved, in fulfillment of the vision. The very same thing, beloved. What does your pain tell you? Have you received the wrong message? The pain came from the vision. And the vision is fulfilled in the time that God set it up. Why does God show us the end? And yet, He backs us up. Come on, this is a word for those of you in ministry. You saw thousands worshiping with you, but you've been struggling with 50 all these years. And having a time, not a time of your life. I don't want to use the word, you know, hell, because people get all bent out of shape and say you cursed and all that stuff. But you're having a time, such a time. Even with the 50, then how can you handle the 1,500 or 2,000 the Lord showed you? This is the process to it. If you would just pass the test with the 50, and God begins to get out of you what He wants, then you will see the promise fulfilled. Joseph saw them. That's why we spent weeks talking about, is this the plan? Now he's governor. Now the brothers have come, and they have bowed down to the earth before him. Watch this. And Joseph saw his brethren, and he knew them, but made himself strange unto them, and spake roughly unto them. And he said unto them, whence come ye? Where did y'all come from? But you notice, beloved, Joseph knew them. I know the Bible will tell us that eventually, but I gotta get it here. I need it here. But his brethren didn't know him. Why? The man that goes through with God stays in the light and in clarity. The ones that embrace Satan and get involved with fighting God in his son's life are blinded. Why wouldn't they know Joseph? Because he's done better than they ever expected. They didn't even know he was still alive. He's the governor of Egypt. They never imagined that their own brother will be governor of Egypt. That's what prejudice and bitterness and jealousy does, beloved. You are blinded to your own possibilities. You are blinded to the plan of God that involves you, your submission. You don't want to submit. You don't want to submit. You want to believe in when you're supposed to be submitting and get blessed in the process. Come on, beloved. God loves us so much. Whether you're submitting or the one leading, let us all get blessed and prosper in what God has sent us to. Such a wonderful season. Yes, the world is getting darker, but God is on the move. The time for your fulfillment is here. I can see this is going to be 2-3 weeks of this. Hallelujah. He said, whence come ye? And they said, from the land of Canaan to buy food. And Joseph knew his brethren. He says it again. But they knew him not. He knew them, but they didn't know him. Do you know why? I answered it before, but the Lord just gave me more light. You see, why didn't they know Joseph? And why did Joseph know them? Because Joseph followed God and has arisen. But beloved, even though it is now, 13 plus 20, and that is probably 20 something years later, they looked the same or worse. They haven't bettered any because they didn't move with God. But Joseph moved on, grew, living in the pleasures of Egypt and the wealth and the power. Come on. And then they would still look so country and so just like the shepherds they were. They hadn't moved. So they couldn't recognize the man in his breakthrough. But Joseph knew them. Are you still in the same place? Are you, as my pastor used to say years ago, stuck in the mud of your experiences? And you haven't bettered any, haven't progressed any, still think the same. After 20 years, still think the same. Come on, beloved. I'm correcting you. I'm giving the promise to those that are ready to graduate. The time for your breakthrough has finally come. Are you ready for the breakthrough? Or are you stuck? Are you stuck, beloved? It's time for your movement. It's time for your elevation. Stand for your crowning. God is on the move. Join the train of God's glory. You will be blessed. Amen and amen. I can't wait to get back into it next week. We love you. God bless you. We'll see you. Bye-bye.